السلام عليكم مدام.
السلام عليكم مام. আসসালামু আলাইকুম ম্যাডাম।
সৌরভ, তোর স্পিকারটা অফ কর, মিউট কর।
السلام عليكم
السلام
ميم.
عليكم
আসসালামু আলাইকুম ম্যাম।
হ্যালো ম্যাম,
ম্যামের কথা কিছু শুনতে পাওয়া যাচ্ছে না? না
না না, ম্যামের কথা কিছু শুনে যাচ্ছে।
ম্যামের স্পিকার
অফ নেই।
Yes, so can you hear me?
Assalamu alaikum, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Wa alaikum
assalam.
How are you, ma'am?
I'm feeling good. Not good. Not better.
Assalamu alaikum, ma'am.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Assalamu
alaikum, ma'am. Wa alaikum
assalam.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Wa alaikum assalam. Ma'am, I am very sick.
Wait, just wait, please. Okay, so please, all students are come on the mic. Just turn on your camera. Okay, Mohammad Ali, Mohammad Hassan,
yes, ma'am.
Arifulak, Rakib,
yes,
Animesh.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
yes.
And Rukun.
Yes, madam.
And where is Sakin? And where is Mayadul Islam? Where is Maruf?
On duty, ma'am.
Okay. So, let me start. Okay. So we will continue. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So should we start? Just,
yes, ma'am.
Just open your page. The properties of nucleotides bases affect the three-dimensional structure of nucleic acids. Okay.
Okay.
Free pyrimidines. Have you seen?
Free pyrimidine and pyrosine.
Yes, yes. Our weekly basic compounds.
Ma'am?
All of you can see?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, should I start?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay, okay. So, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Free pyrimidines and purines are weakly basic compounds and thus are called bases. So here we are talking about the properties of nucleotides bases affect three-dimensional structure of nucleic acid. Okay.
Yeah.
So in the free pyrimidines,
okay,
and purines. So what is the purine? Tell me fast. Arifukal, come on the mic and cam. जितना शोर कहाँ हो रहा है वो अपना माइक म्यूट कर ले जो भी ट्रैफिक के बीच में बैठा हुआ है.
Shut up. Tom.
Okay, what is the purine? I'm asking. What is the purine? I'm asking. Rukun? Rukun?
Yeah.
What is the purine?
Actually, I am past.
Purine is a heterocyclic organic compound.
Purine is a heterocyclic
organic compound.
Organic compound.
It is water soluble.
Tony. Adenine, cytosine, and thymine is the purine.
Yes, ma'am.
And uracil is the pyrimidine. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am. Okay.
You must have to keep in your mind this name. Four are the purines. Guanine, cytosine, adenine, and thymine. Okay. So purine and pyrimidine common in DNA and RNA are aromatic molecules. So both both purine and pyrimidines are common in DNA and RNA. So it's a property with important consequence for the structure, for electron distribution and light absorption of nucleic acids. Okay, so the most important consequences, the most important features for the structure. Which structure? It's the aromatic molecules of DNA and RNA. Okay, purine and pyrimidine. Always purine is present in the DNA. And pyrimidine is present in the RNA.
RNA.
Okay. Purine always is present in the DNA. And, yes.
Pyrimidine always in the RNA.
Okay. And both are the aromatic molecules.
Hello.
Okay. And molecules and our property with important consequence. Please keep silence.
Rukun, mute karo.
Keep silence. So it's the main important property. Property is the consequences for the structure and electronic distributions and light absorptions of nucleic acids. Okay.
Okay.
And electron decolorization among atoms in the ring gives most of bond in the ring partial double bond characters. Always they are the in the double bond. One result is that pyrimidines are planar molecules and purines are barely near. Sorry. And very nearly planar with a slightly pucker. Free pyrimidines and purine bases may exist in two or more tautomeric forms. Hello? Depending on the pH. Okay. So purine and pyrimidines both are exist in two or more tautomeric forms. Like this structure form is the blue. Given blue, and it is totally depending upon their pH. Like uracil, for example, occur in a lactam and double lactam forms. So the structure is shown in 8.2. Just look at the 8.2.
Yes, ma'am.
And the it's a tautomeres that predominates at pH 7. I think as we study the other chemicals and other structures, so I think pH 7 is the neutral and the suitable pH for all chemicals, for all, you can say, all compounds.
Yeah.
pH 7 is the standard. I think so. It's according to me. So all nucleotides, bases absorb UV light. Okay, all nucleotides bases absorb UV light and nucleic acids are characterized by a strong absorption at wavelength near 260
nm.
Yeah, it's a frequency. Yeah. It's a wavelength and frequency. Okay,
UV light frequency.
Yeah, UV light, ultraviolet rays.
Ultraviolet, yeah.
Yes, ultraviolet rays. So, and nucleic acid are characterized by the strong absorption and wavelength, okay, near 260 nm. Okay, so look at the
260 nanometers.
Yeah, nanometer, exactly. It's a frequency. Just remember and highlight, Dico, it's a optimum pH is a 7, and all nucleotides absorb UV light like UV radiations, and nucleic acids are characterized by strong absorption. Like the nucleic acid are stronger for the absorption of wavelength of the light, UV light. It maybe comes from the sun. Okay.
Yes.
Can you hear me clearly?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
So give me a positive response.
Okay, ma'am.
Shajid. Is he a new student?
Yes, ma'am.
Every day newcomers? I don't think so, my God.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, yes, say.
Ma'am, here.
Shajib Kumar. I can't hear what are you saying.
Internet problem maybe, ma'am.
So please turn on your camera. Mahmood Abdullahi. Abdullahi, please come on the cam.
Madam, I'm on the way to go home from my office.
Okay, okay. So, please turn off your mic. Please mute your mic. Don't make any noise. I don't want. Okay. So the purine and pyridine bases are hydrophobic and relatively insoluble in water at the near neutral pH of the cell. Ariful Haq, please come on the cam. Okay. Mm-hmm. Don't turn off your camera.
Okay.
And the purine and pyridine bases are hydrophobic and relatively insoluble in water and the near neutral pH of the cell. So at acidic or alkaline pH, the bases become charged and their solubility in water is increases. So hydrophobic stacking interaction in which two or more bases positioned with the planes of their rings parallel and like a stack of coins are one of two important modes of interaction between bases in nucleic acids. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Arif, you can mute your mic because it's a very noisy. Yeah. And all of them are can open your mic. So the stacking also involves a combination of van der Waals and dipole interaction between the bases. So here is the bonding between the bonds. Okay, between the nucleic acid in the nucleic acid, the bonding in the form of like interaction between the dipole to dipole. Okay, so base stacking helps to minimize contact of bases with water, and base stacking interaction are very important in stabilizing the three-dimensional structure of nucleic acids. So come to the next. The functional group of pyrimidines and purines are rings. The functional groups of pyrimidines and purines are ring nitrogens, carbonyl groups, and exocyclic amino groups. So hydrogen bonds involving, who is make a noise?
তার মিউট করা না মিউট করে দেখ
অনিমেশ দা মাইকে মিউট করে দেন
মাইকে মিউট করুন
মিউট তো করা মিউট করা তো
আচ্ছা ওকে
আচ্ছা বলেন কি হবে তাহলে মিউট করা হবে
আসসালামু আলাইকুম ম্যাডাম
ওয়ালাইকুম আসসালাম থ্যাঙ্কস ফর ইওর কামিং ওকে And please do concentrate on your topic. Okay. I will be thankful to you if you will give an attention. So, the functional group of pyrimidines and purines are ring nitrogens, carbonyl groups, and exocyclic groups. Exocyclic amino groups. So hydrogen bonds involving the amino and carbonyl groups are the most important mode of interaction between.
Ma'am, here functional group pyrimidines and purine both.
Yes, functional group of okay. pyrimidines and purines both are. Okay. In okay. this chapter, we are studying for both pyrimidines and purines. Okay, but the difference is the pyrimidines is involved in the RNA, and purines is depend or is involved in from the DNA. Okay, almost all their arrangement and their presence is almost the same, like RNA or DNA. Okay, both are the same, but. Yes.
Thank you, madam. Madam.
Yes.
My
yes.
name is Olivish.
Yes. Yes.
I go to leave. But Why? I am very sick because I am left uric stone in operation. I say, Rovivar, Friday.
Sorry.
Madam, I yes. go to leave.
Why?
Because but I am very sick. Because I am left uric stone and tomorrow to yesterday OT হয়েছে OT.
Okay, okay. If you are not feeling well, so you may go. Okay. So have you taken this sheet?
Hello?
Doctor?
No, I'm asking, have you taken this sheet?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, so just read out this. And if you have any problem, you may ask in the next class, okay?
Okay, okay, okay.
If you have any problem, or you can coordinate with two other class fellows, classmates.
Because left uric stone.
No problem, no problem. Okay, just read this chapter lecture.
Okay,
and
okay.
If you have any Thank problem, you. No problem, no problem. Take care of yourself. Okay. Okay. Allah okay. bless you. Allah
okay,
bless
thank you.
You. No problem. Okay. Allah Hafiz. Take care. So. So we continue.
Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So here is the hydrogen bond involving the amino and carbonyl groups are the most important. Please just mute your mic.
এখানে ম্যাডাম মিউট করতে বলছে তারপরে বুঝলাম না কেন এরকম করছে সব
So hydrogen bonds involving the amino and carbonyl groups are the most important mode of interaction between two and occasionally three or four complementary strands of nucleic acids. So it's a hydrogen bond, okay? And this bond, hydrogen bond is involving in amino because when nucleic acid is formed, so the there is the amino and carboxyl group is involved in this interaction with each other. Okay, so these are the most important for interaction between two, and occasionally, maybe three, maybe four, as a complementary strands of nucleic acid. So hydrogen bond is formed, hydrogen bond is involved. And the most common hydrogen bonding patterns are also are those defined by James D. Watson and Francis Crick in 1953. So please highlight from the functional group of pyrimidine from the starting. Please highlight this. All of you, please highlight this one. The functional group of purine and pyrimidines are the ring of nitrogen. Yeah, these are, and the hydrogen bond involving the amino and carbonyl groups. Please highlight this one. Okay, this is the most important. Comes in the form of MCQs. It may becomes in the descriptive. It may becomes in the form of short answers. Question. Okay, yeah. So please highlight almost. Thank you.
Ma'am, tell us again.
Okay. So by James D. Watson and Francis Crick in 1953, in which a bond is specifically to T or U and G bonds to C. Okay. So tell me, what is a T and what is U and what is G and what is C?
Hydronine, uracil, guanine.
Hydronine, uracil, guanine.
Cytosine.
And cytosine. Good. Thank you so much for giving me a positive response. So
welcome.
So to ek se badhkar ek ho. So these two types of base pairs. These two types of base pairs predominates in double-stranded DNA and RNA. Okay, so here we are talking about the structure of DNA and RNA. So these two types of base pairs predominates in double-stranded. Like you, as you know, that DNA structure is a double-stranded.
This one.
It's a letter-like structure. Okay, so these two pairs, like guanine and cytosine and thymines, and make each other at the bond form. And it's a double-stranded. And the tautomeres shown in 8.2 are responsible for these parameters. It is a specific pairing of bases that permits the duplication of genetic information. Exactly. So here we can say that thymine, guanine, cytosine, they are responsible for the specific pairing, and these bases permit the duplication of genetic information. Okay, so come to the next, like a summary. Okay, so Rukun, just read out this summary and explain. This summary is the overall, you can say, the whole topic, whatever we have studied. So you can see in the summarize. So please unmute your mic and then read out and explain.
A nucleotide consists of a nitrogenous bases, purine and pyrimidine. Purine, ma'am, thiamine, uracil, guanine,
just read out,
sorry. A pentose sugar and one or more phosphate group. Nucleic acids are polymer of nucleotides joined together by phosphodiester linkage between the five pair hydroxyl group of one pentose and three pair hydroxyl group of the next. There are two types of nucleic acid, RNA and DNA. The nucleotides in RNA contain ribose.
Wait. Just tell me what do you understand from point one? It's just a summary. I have told you. Don't worry. Don't feel any hesitation. Okay. Just say. Don't worry. It's a wrong or right. Don't worry. Just say.
Ma'am, pentose sugar, both purine and pyrimidine bases, and one or more phosphate group. Together by phosphodiester linkage between key five pair and five pair hydroxyl groups and of one pentose and three pair hydroxyl group of next.
Then, so what do you understand? What do you think? Muhammad Ali, can you explain?
Nucleotide joined between five pair and three pair.
It means that a nucleotide, just listen, okay? It means that we are studied about the nucleotide. So nucleotide consists or have a nitrogenous base. What's the nitrogenous base? Nitrogenous bases is a purine and pyrimidine. Okay. So nucleotides consist of purine and pyrimidine. And these are also called a nitrogenous base. And a pentose sugar and one or more phosphate group.
Yes, ma'am.
And nucleic acids are polymers of nucleotides. And they join by a polydiester linkage between 5-2 hydroxyl group and of one pentose and the 3 hydroxyl group of the next. Okay?
Okay.
So, just is step 5' prime hydroxyl group and in 3' prime hydroxyl group.
Yes. One 5 hydroxyl group of one pentose.
Yes.
Okay? One pentose, 5 hydroxyl group is from the pentose, only one pentose, okay? So there are two types of nucleic acids. Now we can see what is, which type, how many types, there are two types of nucleic acids, RNA and DNA.
And DNA.
Okay, two types of nucleic acids. Yes. The nucleotide, just highlight this one, the first point and the second point, highlight, okay? So, Arif, sabko apni zaban mein bata do ki jo main bol rahi hu, highlight kar le, to uska matlab hai highlight kar le, main exam mein usme se pooch sakti hu. Aur main isme se hi poochungi, uske ilawa kahin se main nahi poochungi paper mein. To jo main highlight bol rahi hu, this is the most important, theek hai? Sabko bata do apni zaban mein.
Yes, ma'am. ম্যাম যেগুলো যে হাইলাইট করে দিচ্ছে কি যেগুলো দেখতেও আসলাম যেটা বারবার বলতেছে সেটাই পরীক্ষাতে আসবে ম্যাম এটাই বলতেছে আপনারা সবাই এটা একটু কষ্ট করে একটু হাইলাইট করে নেন মার্কার দিয়ে বুঝতে পারছেন কি হয়েছে ভাই
সো হাইলাইট দিস পয়েন্ট 1 এন্ড পয়েন্ট 2 দ্য হোল সেন্টেন্স হোল পয়েন্ট 1 okay, and the second, just highlight. So the nucleotides in RNA contains RNA. Here we are talking about RNA. It's a ribose, and commonly and common pyrimidine bases are uracil, as we studied, and cytosine. And in DNA, the nucleotides contain 2 deoxyribose. The common pyrimidine bases and are thymine and cytosine. The primary purines are adenine and guanine. And in both RNA and DNA.
Ma'am, here nucleic acid in DNA common.
Sorry?
Thymine and cytosine. Cytosine and thymine common.
No.
In DNA.
Wait, what are you saying? Please ask again. In DNA.
In DNA, thymine and cytosine common.
Saying, I don't understand.
Like RNA, cytosine common.
Like RNA,
in RNA,
you
common.
Who is asking?
Rukun Ujjaman.
Okay. Yes, Rukun. Ask again. Rukun.
Ma'am.
Yes. Ask again. Rukun.
Abar bolo Rukun. Ki bolchho seta madam ke abar bolo. Madam bujhte parna.
Rukun. I think it's an internet problem.
They are in DNA.
No. What are you saying? I didn't get your point because due to internet problem in your site. At your site. So now come to the next. 8.2 nucleic acid structure. 8.2.
Yes,
all you have.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. So DNA is a double helix that stores genetic information.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we studied and just highlight this whole this paragraph. Okay, just highlight this paragraph. This is the most important. DNA is a double helix that stores genetic information. So DNA was first, just highlight. Okay, just read it. Mohammad Hassan.
Yes, ma'am.
Please give your attention on your studies, okay? Don't look at this like this, like this. Okay, I'm here. You can see. No, you can see after class. Like you can see upper side, lower side, right, left. You can see after class. Okay.
Yes. Okay, ma'am.
I'm sorry, please don't mind, okay?
So okay,
because,
ma'am.
Because I'm taking your class, because you can see I'm feeling very severe pain in my eyes. You can see like this. So it's very exertion for me because I'm taking your class from the laptop and this radiation is effect on my eyes. You know, as yesterday, I was taking your class. My another eye is also affected due to using laptop. Okay, so please give do cooperate with me. Okay, thank you. So come to that, DNA was first isolated and characterized by Friedrich Meister in 1868. He called the phosphorus containing substances nucleic. So DNA was first isolated, or you can say first discovered, and they are characterized by Friedrich Meister. And you can remember this name like fried egg, fried rice. Yes, fried rice. So you can remember like fried and rich. Rich means rich and poor.
Yes.
So fried rich. And my sister, you can learn. Okay. It's up to you. I don't have any other name like to compare like this. So in 1868, so he called the phosphorus containing substances nuclein. Yes. Not until the 1940s, with the work of Oswald T. Avery, Colin McLeod, and Mackling McCarty, was there compelling evidence that DNA was a genetic material. So in 1940s, with work of these scientists were working with Oswald T. Avery, okay, McLeod and Mackling. So they are compelling evidences, because these three scientists have done many researches, and they compelling overall. So the evidence that the DNA was the genetic material. Okay. Avery and his colleague found that an extract of virulent strains of bacterium. Streptococcus pneumonia. And we will study, I hope, in the microbiology, that what is a Streptococcus pneumonia, and these bacteria cause the pneumonia. Okay.
Yes.
So it causing, and when they have researches in many times, so they discovered that they discovered that this is causing disease in mice. Okay, they have worked on this like mice. They are taking the mice and they're taking the blood from the mice, and further researches show that the Streptococcus pneumonia and pneumonia where, because pneumonia is a scientist, they give the name of pneumonia. Okay. Pneumonia is the name of scientist, which has given the name of pneumonia, and it is you can say it is caused by the Streptococcus organism. Name is the Streptococcus, so that's why it is called the Streptococcus pneumonia, and it's first discovered in the mice. As you know, you have seen that the pneumonia is present in many human beings. Like further patient is suffering from pneumonia and suffering, but no, basically it is causing disease from the mice. Okay, it is causing from the mice. This is a disease and it is caused from the mice, but due to the unfavorable condition, unfavorable environment. Okay, many contamination due to many unsterilized condition. You can say not a hygienic condition, so pneumonia may cause, and the main basic cause is the pneumonia is the pollutions, which can cause pneumonia, like air through air. We inhale the
Water pollution.
Exactly. Which we can inhale the from the air and inhale and in the oxygen through the oxygen, bad air insert in the lungs, and maybe this organism, yes, maybe this organism carry in the lungs and infect the infected lung. Okay, so but the basic this disease is diagnosed from the mice, not from the humans. Okay. Humans are affected due to which?
Yes, ma'am.
Due to which? Pollutions.
Pollutions. Water pollution, air pollution, airborne disease,
water pollutions. Many sources can cause pneumonia. Okay, and mice could be used to transform a non-virulent strain of the same bacterium in a virulent strain. So they were able to demonstrate that various chemical tests that it was DNA from the virulent strains. What's the virulent strain? Not protein, polysaccharides or RNA, for example, that carry the genetic information for virulence. Okay, one bacteria is a virulent strain, and maybe various chemical reactions have done, but it was a DNA. That's a virulent strain, which maybe from the RNA, maybe from the polysaccharide, and it was the DNA and that carry the genetic information for the virulence. So then in 1952, experiments by Alfred D. Hershey and Martha Chase, in which they studied the infection of bacterial cells by a virus, bacteriophage. I hope you know what's a bacteriophage. It's a cycle, life cycle of the bacteria, which causes infection in the human body or animal body.
Yeah.
Okay. So here's the. They studied the infection of bacterial cell by a virus, bacteriophage, with radioactively labeled DNA or protein. Okay, you can say DNA or protein, it's the same thing almost, because when we are talking about a protein, so it's a nucleosides. Okay, it's a nucleosides, obviously protein and DNA is almost the same. So removed by remaining doubt that DNA, not protein, carried the genetic information. Okay, but remove and remaining doubt, but there are that DNA, not protein. Okay, DNA carried the genetic information. Protein are not carried the genetic information.
Yeah.
Okay.
Genetic information is a protein.
No, genetic information only contain the DNA, not protein. And another important clue to the structure of DNA come from the work of Erwin Chargaff and his colleague in the late of 1940s. And these researches have done in 1940s, okay? When you were not available in this world.
Yeah.
Any doubt?
No, ma'am. Okay, doubt, no confusion.
Okay. No, I think I was thinking that maybe Muhammadul Hasan,
yes, ma'am,
was present on that time in 1940s. Yeah. You will be there?
No, ma'am.
No, if you will be there, then you can share this history. We are very excited to know this about you for this history. Okay. So they found that the four nucleotides again वैसे ये लोग भी बड़े खड़े दिमाग थे, इसका पीछा नहीं छोड़ा इन लोगों ने, साइंटिस्टों ने, खुद सब चले गए, हम लोगों को फंसा गए. चलो so they found that
तो मर के निकल गया, लेकिन झमेला को मेरे माता हम सबको माथे ऊपर दे गया,
हमें फंसा गए. चलो आगे बढ़ते हैं. They found that the four nucleotide bases of DNA occur in different ratios in the DNA of different organisms, and the amount of certain bases are closely related. These data collected from the DNA as of a great many different species. So led Chargaff to the following conclusion that the basis, the base composition of DNA. Just highlight this paragraph also, the whole yes, paragraph. Yeah, just highlight. Okay.
Yeah, ma'am.
The base composition. Yeah.
इतना बड़ा पैराग्राफ कैसे खत्म करोगा?
नहीं कैसे सिर्फ समझ लो हो जाएगा. इजी पेपर बनाऊंगी, टेंशन नहीं लो. ठीक है, सिर्फ समझ लो, बेसिक पॉइंट्स को लो. हाईलाइट इसलिए कह रही हूँ, अपनी वर्डिंग में लिख लेना, रट्टा नहीं लगाना. अपने फ्रेंड्स को भी बता दो, रट्टा नहीं लगाओ, रट्टे से मुझे चिढ़ है. जो बंदा देख के छापेगा ना, उसको जीरो मार्क मिलेगा. जो अपनी वर्डिंग में लिखे, हाँ बस कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर करो, अपनी वर्डिंग में लिखो, पूरे मार्क्स में
नहीं छापूंगा.
ओके मैम,
अपना मर्जी को, अपना मर्जी.
हाँ बस कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर हो. मैं कहती हूँ मेरे स्टूडेंट का, तुम अपनी जबान में समझा दो सबको कि बस कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर हो, वर्डिंग में कुछ नहीं रखा. हर साइंटिस्ट की, हर बंदे की अपनी वर्डिंग है. मेरी अलग वर्डिंग है, आपकी अलग वर्डिंग है, साइंटिस्ट की अलग वर्डिंग है, लेकिन कॉन्सेप्ट एक होना चाहिए. कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर करो, बस अपनी वर्डिंग में लिखो.
Okay.
गलत भी लिखोगे मार्क्स दूंगी. वर्डिंग गलत होगी, कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर होगा, वर्डिंग गलत होगी तो, लेकिन कॉन्सेप्ट गलत नहीं होना चाहिए,
तो भी मार्क मिलेगा, तो भी मार्क मिलेगा.
अगर कॉन्सेप्ट सही होगा, कॉन्सेप्ट की बात कर रही हूँ. ठीक है,
ठीक है,
अपनी जबान में सबको समझा दो. हाँ कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर करो. हाँ बस पढ़ के कॉन्सेप्ट देखो, जो जो हाईलाइट करवाती जा रही हूँ उन सबको बस समझ लो कि ये ऐसा है.
ओके.
साइंटिस्ट का नाम नहीं भी याद हो रहा, भाड़ में डालो. बस कॉन्सेप्ट याद रखो कि डीएनए का क्या कॉन्सेप्ट है, उसके पास इंफॉर्मेशन क्या है, उसके पास नॉलेज क्या है, वो क्या रखता है. वो घर वालों की नॉलेज रखता है, जेनेटिक मटेरियल की इंफॉर्मेशन रखता है. ठीक है, ये सारा ध्यान में रखना बस. ठीक है,
ठीक है.
हाँ अगर साइंटिस्ट नहीं याद हो रहे तो नहीं करना. ठीक है, और जैसे पढ़ लो और मुझे बताते जाना सब. फिर मैं बता रही हूँ, हर क्लास में मुझे बताते जाना. ये पीछे जिसका भी बच्चा रो रहा है ना, खामोश करा दो उसे, वरना तुम सबको रोना पड़ेगा. तो मैं ये कह रही थी कि जो नहीं आ रहा समझ में, जो याद नहीं हो रहा है, समझ में नहीं आ रहा, तो मुझसे पूछ लेना, मैं बता दूंगी. ठीक है, अगर साइंटिस्ट के नाम, हाँ साइंटिस्ट के नाम नहीं याद हो रहे, कोई मसला नहीं है. बस कॉन्सेप्ट याद रखो कि डीएनए के बारे में क्या है, न्यूक्लियोटाइड क्या है, उसके कॉन्सेप्ट क्या है, बस अपनी जबान में याद कर लो. ठीक है, अपनी वर्डिंग में लिख देना, इंग्लिश में भी अपनी वर्डिंग में लिख देना. ठीक है, मुझे सिर्फ कॉन्सेप्ट चाहिए. गलत भी लिख दो कोई मसला नहीं, लेकिन कॉन्सेप्ट सही हो, कॉन्सेप्ट चाहिए मुझे. याद नहीं करना, इधर बिठाना, इधर याद नहीं करना, इधर बिठाना. हाँ चलो आगे चलते हैं. सो द कंक्लूजन दैट द बेस कंपोजिशन ऑफ डीएनए जनरली वेरीज फ्रॉम वन स्पीशीज टू अनदर. सो डीएनए स्पेसिमेन, डीएनए द बेस कंपोजिशन ऑफ डीएनए जनरली वेरीज फ्रॉम वन स्पीशी. इट मींस द डीएनए कंपोजिशन, द बेसिक कंपोजिशन ऑफ डीएनए, ओके, is different. Composition of DNA is different from one species to another.
Yes, ma'am. Okay?
Like animal species is different from human species.
Human being.
Okay, number one point. Number second is the DNA specimen isolated from different tissues. Okay, different tissues of the same species have the same base composition. If you're taking the cat, if you are taking the CAT, so you can the same same number, same species, same number, same base composition, but different tissues. If you have two CATs, one and one, so both are the same, but tissues are different. Okay. Yeah. So DNA specimen is isolated from the different tissues of the same species. If you are talking about the human, so humans have the same or same composition, but the different tissues.
But different tissues.
Yes. Number third is the base composition of the DNA in a given species does not change with an organism's age. Okay. It yes, will ma'am. Not change. It will not take the organism age. For example, let me explain this. For example, we are talking about RF. Okay, when RF was a child, so the DNA is the same composition. Now he is grown up. So now at this stage, he is the same as he as is the childhood stage. Okay, so yes. so here is a given species does not change with an organism age,
nutritional
or changing environment.
Environment.
Got it?
Yeah.
Got it.
Okay. Good. Concept clear?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay.
So here sense is nutritional status, changing environment, but not sense DNA composition.
Should I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
So in all cellular DNA, regardless of the species, the number of adenosine residues is equal to the number of thymidine residues. Okay. So the number of adenosine residues, the number of the adenosine residues is equal to the number of thymidine residues. Okay. And the number of guanine residues is equal to the number of yes. If the number of adenosine is 4, so thymine is also 4. Okay. If adenosine is the 2, so thymine is also 2. Okay. And when guanine is 3, so cytosine is also 3. Okay. Yes. So from the relationship, it follows that the sum of purine residues equals the sum of the pyrimidine residues. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So, okay. I have chosen just selected for you, okay? कि आप लोगों के ऊपर बर्डन ना बने, आप में से जो भी उर्दू समझते हो अपनी जबान में बता देना कि भाई कोई बर्डन ना बने. हाँ, इसलिए मैं बहुत लाइटली लेके चल रही हूँ कि तुम लोगों को कोई प्रॉब्लम ना हो. अगर फिर भी नहीं करोगे ना, फिर देखना तुम लोगों को फेल करना है सबको. मैंने
इंशाल्लाह मैम
क्या फेल होगे? इंशाल्लाह फेल होगे?
नहीं नहीं मैम, बिल्कुल नहीं.
ओके, इंशाल्लाह.
ये कोई चाहता है?
नहीं, उसने बोला इंशाल्लाह. मैंने
कहा इंशाल्लाह,
उसकी उम्मीदें होंगी कुछ. ये सोच लो तुम्हारी तुम लोगों की टीचर एक आंख से पढ़ा रही है इस वक्त. अच्छा, खैर. ओके, सो द क्वांटिटेटिव ओके द क्वांटिटेटिव रिलेशनशिप समटाइम्स कॉल्ड अ शेरग्रिफ रूल्स वर कंफर्म्ड
मैम.
यस,
यू हैव problem, you can close the class.
Sorry,
you have pain, ma'am, your eyes. So you can close the class today.
No, actually, I just wind up from this topic and I will have to go because my mother is hospitalized. She is suffering from the liver problem, liver infection. So I will have to go hospital and.
Ma'am, you may leave.
No.
Leave now, please.
If you want, ma'am.
No. Let me complete. No. It's my responsibility.
Ma'am, it's okay, ma'am.
No problem, ma'am.
No. I just manage your timetable. So please do cooperate with me. Then I will finish today. So next class, we will start the microbiology. Okay.
I hope today our last class this subject.
Yes. Okay. So please do cooperate with me.
Okay, I'm sure.
Just to look at this paragraph, the quantitative relationship, sometimes called Chargraff rules. Okay, just read out this. Okay, after class, maybe in coming week, you just read out this. Okay, just read out. Okay. There is nothing special, but just read out. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Now come to the next. Okay, James Watson and Francis Crick relied on this accumulated information about DNA to set about the deducing in its structure. Give me a minute, okay? Kya work kar rahe the? अच्छा खैरियत तो है ना चले से हाँ सो जेम्स वाटसन एंड फ्रांसिस क्रिक रिलाइड ऑन दिस एक्यूमुलेटेड इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट डीएनए टू सेट अबाउट डिड्यूसिंग इन स्ट्रक्चर इन 1953 दे पोस्टुलेटेड अ थ्री डायमेंशनल मॉडल ऑफ डीएनए ओके दे पोस्टुलेटेड अ थ्री डायमेंशनल मॉडल ऑफ डीएनए structure that accounted for all the available data. It consists of two helical DNA chain, like two helical-like structure, like ladder-like structure, wound around the same axis to form right-handed double helix. For an explanation of the right or left-handed sense of a helical structure. Okay, helical structure. So the hydrophilic backbones of alternating deoxyribose and phosphate groups are on the outside of the double helix. Okay, just also highlight this one from James Watson to double helix. Okay.
Okay.
So next, the purine and pyrimidine bases, and just highlight this one also. The purine and pyrimidine base of both strands are stacked inside the double helix with the hydrophobic and nearly planar ring structures very close together and perpendicular to the long axis. The offset pairing of the two strands create major groove and minor groove on the surface of the duplex. Okay, so duplex. Each nucleotide base of one strand is paired. Just highlight this overall, paragraph. So a strand is paired in the same plane with the base of the other strand. Okay, and highlight this one, Watson. This is the most important. Okay, Watson and Crick found that. Just keep in your mind whatever I am saying. What is the most important?
Yeah.
So all of you are intelligent. So Watson and Crick found that hydrogen bonded base pair illustrated guanine with cytosine and adenine with thymine. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
And next is the. It is important. After okay, two ma'am. Lines. After two lines. After two lines, it is important to note that. Just highlight this one also. It is important to note that three hydrogen bond can form between guanine and cytosine, symbolized guanine, and triple bond is cytosine. But only two can form between adenine and thymine, and it is symbolized adenine double bond thymine. This is the most important.
Okay, man.
So much good. What?
Yes.
परीक्षा आ गया
ओके
ओके मैम
हाँ गोनीन ट्रिपल बॉन्ड विद द साइटोसिन एंड एडिनिन डबल बॉन्ड विद द थायमिन दिस इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट बच्चा पार्टी ओके
यस मैम
हाँ ओके सो पेयरिंग ऑफ दिस बेसिस Other guanine and cytosine and adenine with thymine tends to destabilize the double helical structure. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Now, come to the summary.
Yes, ma'am.
समरी पे आओ जान छुड़ाओ कैसे सबकी चेहरों पे मुस्कुराहट आ जाती है
हम तो बात चलो है ना
Yes, चलो समरी में स्टार्ट करें समरी कैसे चले
चले
इतना छोड़ दिया तुम लोगों को शॉर्ट कर करके दिया बीबी तसल्ली नहीं हो रही है तुम लोगों की
क्यों
इस तरह कोई भी नहीं करता इस लेवल पर आकर इस लेवल पे कोई भी नहीं बताता कि ये इस तरह से क्वेश्चंस आएंगे इस तरह से आएगा कहीं मैं रूल्स के खिलाफ भी ना जा रही हूँ इंस्टीट्यूट के
नो 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 मैम रूल्स के खिलाफ क्यों हो
ये आपकी दया है मैम
थैंक यू सो न्यूक्लिक एसिड स्ट्रक्चर आप जल्दी से देखो मेनी लाइंस ऑफ एविडेंस शो दैट द डीएनए बेयर्स जेनेटिक इंफॉर्मेशन सम ऑफ द अर्लीस्ट एविडेंस केम फ्रॉम द एवरी मैक्रोटिल्स व्हिच शो दैट द डीएनए आइसोलेट फ्रॉम वन बैक्टीरियल One bacterial strain can enter and transform the cells of another strain, and doing it with some of the inheritable characteristics of the donor. And the Hershey-Chase experiment showed that the DNA of a bacterial virus, but not as a protein coat, carries the genetic message. Or genetic message or genetic information for replication of the virus in the host cell. Okay. So putting together the available data, Watson and Crick postulated that native DNA consists of two antiparallel chains in a right-handed double helical arrangement, complementary base pairs adenine. Double bond thymine, guanine, triple bond cytosine are formed by hydrogen bonding within the helix. The base pairs are stacked perpendicular to the long axis of the double helix, 3:4 apart with 10.5 base pair per turn. Okay? And okay. Messenger RNA transfer genetic information from DNA to ribose. Highlight this one also. The whole summary. जो जो पढ़ा है ना सबकी summaries को highlight कर लेना.
Okay.
हाँ उसका निचोड़ आ जाएगा paper में. बस अब नहीं बोलूँगी बार बार.
Okay.
देखो आगे
छोटा सा बात था मैं वाला क्वेश्चन कैसे पूछेगा समझ नहीं पाया
मैसेंजर आरएनए ट्रांसफर जेनेटिक इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम डीएनए टू राइबोसोम्स फॉर फोटोसिंथेसिस ओके हां
प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस
एंड ट्रांसफर आरएनए एंड राइबोसोमल आरएनए आर आल्सो इन्वॉल्व इन प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस ओके RNA can be structurally complex. Single RNA strand can fold into hairpins, double-stranded regions, or complex loops. Okay. Now come to the 10.3. Only summary.
Okay,
if you have any problem in the whole topic, you just read out the summary. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
I can't say anything. Okay? Yes. 8.3. Summary. Nucleic acid chemistry. So, native DNA undergoes reversible unwinding and separation of strands, melting, on heating or at extreme of pH, DNA rich in guanine, triple bond cytosine pairs have higher melting points than DNA rich in adenine, A double bond T pairs. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
So here they are saying that separation of strands melting when you give the heat to DNA exposure of heat you give the any heat to the DNA so the strands is separate obviously when you give the heat so it's just separate the strand the melting on heating okay or extreme pH means more than 7 extreme pH than 7 pH so DNA rich in guanine triple bonds cytosine have higher melting point, okay?
Yes, sir.
Why higher melting point? Because here is a triple bond, three bond. Here is a triple bond between guanine and cytosine. So it has a higher melting point. Then DNA rich in adenine to thymine, okay? Now next, yeah. DNA is a relatively stable polymer. Spontaneous reactions such as demination of certain bases, hydrolysis of base sugar and glycosyl bonds, radiation induced formation of pyrimidine dimers and oxidative damage occur at very low rate, yet are important because of cells are very low tolerance for changes in its genetic material. Next point, the oligonucleosides of known sequences can be synthesized rapidly and accurately. Okay. The polymerase chain reaction, PCR. PCR is also test.
Yes, ma'am. COVID-19 test now.
Yes.
Polymer chain reaction.
Okay. Provide a convenient and rapid method of amplifying segments of DNA. If the sequences of the ends of the targeted DNA segments are known, routine DNA sequences of gene or short DNA segment is carried out using an automated variation of Sanger didoxide sequences. And the DNA sequences including entire genomes can be efficiently determined.
That's
efficiently determined in hours or days with a range of methods. Okay, with a range of methods including next gen sequences. Now, summary of 8.4, and it's the last. I hope so.
Thank you, ma'am.
Let me finish first. Let me finish first.
Topic, ma'am. No, ma'am. No.
Oh my God. Thank you, thank you. Let me finish first.
Hello.
ये किसने इतनी जल्दी एंट्री दे दी? क्लास खत्म हो रही है. हेलो कौन? अल्लाह अकबर.
आप कौन है?
अभी मैंने स्टार्ट भी नहीं किया. थैंक यू. मैंने कहा पढ़ने तो दो मुझे अल्लाह के बंदो. थैंक यू जान छुड़ा रहे हो तुम लोग. इससे ज्यादा क्या शॉर्ट करूं? समरी उठा उठा के दे रही हूँ, उसी में से बना दूंगी. और इससे ज्यादा क्या शॉर्ट करूंगी तुम लोगों के लिए? मैं खाली मार्कशीट भिजवा दूं, डिग्री भिजवा दूं घर पे.
नहीं चाहिए, वो नहीं चाहिए. थोड़ा सा मेहनत करेगा और थोड़ा सा फल भी मिलेगा.
बस एक बात कह रही हूँ ना, समरी पढ़ लेना, सिर्फ समरी.
और
जो बीच में हाईलाइट करवाया है उसको सिर्फ पढ़ लेना और बस अपनी वर्डिंग में करना. कोई वो नहीं है. बस जैसे एंजाइम्स के नाम याद कर लिए, किसी बैक्टीरिया का नाम याद कर लिया, कोई प्रोसेस अगर है उसमें कि क्या क्या है, हाई मेल्टिंग है, लो मेल्टिंग है, कितने स्ट्रैंड्स हैं, क्या है, बस सिंपल से है. ज्यादा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड नहीं है. चलो अबे अदर फंक्शंस ऑफ न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स. एटीपी इज द सेंट्रल कैरियर. एटीपी इज द सेंट्रल कैरियर ऑफ केमिकल एनर्जी इन सेल्स. The presence of an adenosine moiety in a variety of enzyme cofactor may be related to binding energy requirements.
ATP pulling in kilo.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
ATP adeno triphosphate.
Sorry, man.
Chemical energy in a cell. The presence of an adenosine moiety is a variety of enzyme cofactor may be related to binding energy requirement. Cyclic AMP formed from ATP in a reaction catalyzed by adenyl cyclase is a common second messenger produced in response of hormones. And other chemical signals. And next is ATP and ADP serve as a neurotransmitter in a variety of signaling pathways. Okay.
Okay.
Now
ADP adeno triphosphate.
Yeah. Hmm? Adenosyl triphosphate and adenosyl triphosphate.
AMP or adenosyl monophosphate.
Okay. Now this chapter is complete, and next class
microbiology,
and let me search which book I prepared. I will share like this. Okay,
ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Any question?
Give us PDF file, please. PDF file, please.
আচ্ছা পিডিএফ ফাইলটা ভাই এটা আমরাই করি ম্যাডাম, এটা শেয়ার করেন, এটা ওই যে বিজিএলসি থেকে আমরা এটা প্রোভাইড করে থাকি. পরবর্তীতে WhatsApp গ্রুপে আপনি পেয়ে যাবেন.
আমাকে এটা লাগবে ম্যাম, যেটা পড়াতে এটা লাগবে
সেটাই আপনাকে দেওয়া হবে. ওইটাই ম্যাম, এটা আমাদের বিজিএলসি তে দিবে, সেখান থেকে এটা আমাদের এখানে আসবে, আমরা WhatsApp এ দিয়ে দেব. এটা
এটা WhatsApp এ আপনি WhatsApp একটু ভালো হয়। হ্যাঁ
আসলে কি এটা আমরা পরে কথা বলবো এই বিষয়ে একটু।
দেখো যে ম্যাম আছে मैंने जो सेंड किया है उसमें से जो मैंने बताया है, जो हाईलाइट करवाया है, मैं बताती जा रही हूँ, मैं फिर कह रही हूँ मुझे नहीं बोलना तुम लोग. मैंने जो हाईलाइट किया है, जो कहा है कि हाईलाइट करो, इसका मतलब है मैं उसमें से पूछूंगी और जितना मैंने चैप्टर्स पढ़ाए हैं, आई थिंक 4 चैप्टर्स पढ़ाए हैं, उनकी समरी भी ना पढ़ो तो फिर तुम लोग बस छत पे जाओ छलांग लगा दो. इससे ज्यादा मैं कुछ नहीं कह सकती.
मैम आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन.
हां
कैन यू टेल मी क्वेश्चन टैग्स और क्वेश्चन पैटर्न्स.
Maybe subjective, maybe subjective, maybe short answers, maybe objectives.
MCQ.
Yeah. Maybe MCQs, maybe subjective, maybe objective. I will not tell you. I will not tell you. Maybe 50%, maybe 50% objective, maybe 50% subjective.
Okay. 100% tell us.
What?
If you say 100% tell us.
100%? What 100%?
Question pattern, ma'am.
Question paper 100%. Okay, give me a favor. कि आप लोग पेपर बना लो मुझे दे देना. पेपर वाले दिन मैं आप लोगों को दे दूंगी.
अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह मैम.
अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह. है सही है ना?
नो नो नो
नो नो सही नहीं.
ये नहीं चाहिए.
इसका वॉल्यूम कैसे तेज होगा?
नॉट नॉट गुड मैडम.
नहीं नहीं आप बोल दो, कोई मसला नहीं है.
यस मैम.
ठीक है ना, आप पेपर बना देना, मुझे बता देना कि ये है, मैं आपको दे दूंगी. मार्क्स भी बता देना कितने दूं.
नहीं मैम, नहीं मैम, ये नहीं चाहिए.
कितनी खुशी हो रही है चेहरे पे, ऐसा कुछ नहीं होने वाला. जितनी फेवर दे दी बहुत है. ठीक है, जितनी फेवर दे दी बहुत है. बस जो हाईलाइट करवाया है समरी को पढ़ लेना, और जो हाईलाइट करवाया उसको देख लेना. आप रट्टा नहीं लगाना, अपनी जबान में समझ लेना, समझने के बाद बस लिख देना. ठीक है?
ओके मैम.
लेकिन इंग्लिश में लिखना, अपनी जबान में नहीं लिखना.
ओके मैम.
मुझे भी एक ट्यूटर रखना पड़ेगा उसे पढ़वाने के लिए.
मुझे ले लिए ना.
क्या बात है, क्या बात है भाई, बड़े ऊंचे जा रहे हो तुम लोग. बस ये कि अल्लाह ताला तुम लोगों की मदद करे, और तुम लोग दुआ करना मेरी आंखें भी सही हो जाए, मेरी अम्मी भी दुआ करना.
व्हाट इज दिस क्या वाले दम.
हां
अबे
क्या बात. ड्यू टू हॉट वेदर हीट वेव. हीट वेव
मैम. आप आई स्पेशलिस्ट कैसे जाए? आई स्पेशलिस्ट कैसे जाए? गो टू आई स्पेशलिस्ट.
या या आई हैव कंसीडर्ड. आई स्पेशलिस्ट को दिखाया है मैंने, उसे कंसीडर किया है. तो वो ड्रॉप्स वगैरह दिए, थोड़ा विजन को देखने में मना किया, लेकिन क्लास लेना तो जरूरी है ना.
इतना जरूरी नहीं है मैम.
नहीं नहीं जरूरी है बेटा.
जरूरी है.
तब ये अच्छा, मेरी मदर के लिए दुआ करना, सब लोग बता रही हूँ.
मैम इंशाल्लाह आई होप इंशाल्लाह की अर्ली रिकवर.
बस उनके लिए दुआ करना, अल्लाह मियां को जल्दी से सही कर दे और वो बस जल्दी से घर आ जाए.
अल्लाह
मेरे को. उम्र क्या है?
नहीं प्रॉब्लम बेटा.
लिवर ऑब्सेस हो गया है.
उसका उम्र क्या है?
लिवर ऑब्सेस. लिवर ऑब्सेस. Inflammation of on liver and pus formation.
Okay. Assalamualaikum, ma'am.
Okay. So okay, I'm going next time, next class, inshallah, Tara.
Inshallah, ma'am.
Awesome.
See you again. Assalamualaikum.
Wait. अब ये सोचो एक आंख के ऊपर इतना बर्डन है, किस किस को नोटिस करूंगी एक आंख से मैं।
मैम साकिन, साकिन नेम नेम इज शौकत हुसैन, शौकत अली ने भी
शौकत अली अली नो बट आई लाइक साकिन, आई लाइक
ओके
साकिन इज द बेस्ट।
आई आल्सो
यस ओके लाफिस इंशाल्लाह ताला
अल्लाह हाफिज
एंड टेक केयर ऑफ यू सर एंड योर मदर आल्सो।
थैंक यू सो मच। Just remember in your prayers, okay? Allah Hafiz.
Allah
Hafiz. Allah Hafiz.
Hey, Shorab, tu samne
hai. Hey, ebe hey.
তুই
আমার হুসেন মানে তো স্কিল লাগ গিয়া, আমি হুসেন নাকি আমি ক্লাসের দেরিতে ঢুকছি, তুই চুপে যাবে ঢুকছি, তোর বেড়া এটা সহ্য হয় না কেন?
আমি তো জানি তুই চুপে যাবে পরে ঢুকছ, আমি তো কি বলছি ম্যাম বলছি ম্যাম ওই ইতনা কনসেন্ট্রেশন দিয়ে ক্লাস পে পাইলেছে ঠিক আছে, প্রথম থেকে সে এত কনসেন্ট্রেশন দিয়েছে।
এই শুন এনে বস সেলাইন লেগুয়েজ করিস না ভাই, কারণ এগুলো রেকর্ডিং করে রাখা হয় কিন্তু সবগুলা।
আই হোপ ইউ নো দ্যাট আই এম
তোরা গ্রুপে ইয়ে আই তাহলে মেসেঞ্জারে
গ্রুপে যা এটা ভালো কাটে গুলো সব রেকর্ড হয়ে যায়। কালকে আমি যে কালকে অফিসে যা দেখছি আমি এগুলো অফিসে যা কালকে দেখছি
আচ্ছা ওকে এক দিন